Hello friends, I'm Chi. Yeah, today I'll be telling you a whole lot of things. Why you need to go to Agencia delle Entrate, residence, lawyer, even your rental cittadinanza, a whole lot of things, even documents too, how you can get it so easily if you have, you like to know. Alright, if you're here for the first time, why don't you subscribe? Because here you get information that will keep informed, thrilled, updated, transform you. Because information is power, key to every man's life, man. If you are my friend, you already know. I will say a big thank you to you because you have been doing the wondrous work by sharing to your friends on WhatsApp, Facebook, telling them that she is here, spreading love also. And you is watching me for the first time, welcome on board. Okay, just subscribe, okay? That's best you can do because you are the reason why I'm here. Without you, I won't be here at all. So thank you, okay? All right, now, where do I start from? Should I go back to home or here? All right, now listen, Retouch That Dancer, like they said, will be paid on the 26th, 27th. Remember to do one thing, spend that money, plan about it now, because sometimes this money usually disappear from cards, you know, sometimes whooping 300, 400, big as 500 normally disappear. Like I used to tell you, poster would tell you, it's a card that is not secured. So now, even now, the government is saying that, hey, people taking this money now have to do communal work, cleaning the streets, the gutters, dirty places, parking, you know, all those things. So now, because communal say, oh, we can't let them take this money for free just like that. Well, it's still good if you can give them the money and give them the job, no problem. All we need is the job after all. So at least we are working for the money. You know, some of my haters will say, hey, why are you all talking about bonus? Every time you're talking about bonus, what's wrong with you? But let me tell you something. If it's better for you, for some people, life is not better for them. So they need this bonus to survive. You don't have to insult people who are taking bonuses. Even Italians take bonuses too. I don't know why you're hating. I don't know why you're hating. You know, I realized something. Some people who cannot get this bonus are always the ones who are more angry. You know, there's no job. Lockdown, people are losing jobs like crazy. And you're saying I should not talk about bonus when other Italian channels are talking about bonuses to their own people. Go to CAF, you see Italians there lining up applying for bonuses. And you're telling me, hey, why are you always talking about bonus? Tell us something else. Man, if you don't need the money, there are people who need it. I know, there are people who need it. Okay, so please, okay, if you don't need it, maybe if you have too much, give me so I can share to some people too. Alright, that's cheat talking. Yes, now moving straight. Bonus pays, I remember like I told you, it's ongoing. For families, even single people. Now you'll be thinking, hey, I have hospitalita, because somebody is harboring you. Now remember, some people never knew that their residence is still counting in the camp where they've left, you know. Because yes, if you have left SPRA or a camp, you never knew that your residence there is still counting. Some commune will leave it there up to 1 year, 6 months, depending on that commune. Some people 2 years, like I've heard. So now, all you have to do to get in contact with that commune and tell them you want to get the bonus visa. Yeah, people have called me. They told me that it worked that way for them. The commune asked them to come and take it or even send the voucher to them, you know. So please, try to find out if your residence is still active. How can you do that? You can just simply go to any commune, that former commune where you last left, and go to the anagrafe section and tell them, hey, you need residence certificate or the certificate familia. They will give it to you. That's how to know easily, you know, that your residence is still active there. Even you can use it to renew your documents instead of you going to pay people to give you residence to renew your documents, okay? So now, try to know that one, okay? That you can get the bonus pays still if your residence is still active in another commune. All right, now, one intriguing thing happening. Some of you had, let's say you usually have an account in Poster or Bank, but because you have changed some information in your physical code, like name, surname, or the rest of them, even age and the rest of them, or even your sojourn. So because of that, Poster, you cannot access your fund anymore because information have changed. Even you cannot withdraw or even operate on your accounts anymore. So well, you are thinking, what do you do? Poster is telling you they cannot resolve it, telling you long process to do it. Now, all you have to do is just tell them to delete your profile from their system. They should just delete everything so they can start afresh to register yourself with the new information of your name, your new name that you have changed, or the one in your document, to re-register yourself with the new informations you have. That's just the best way to go about it. Instead of you trying to have log ahead with them, just tell them, delete my profile, man, delete it, and put this new information in there. Or you can go to another post after they have deleted it in this one. You can go to the next one and then open a new account with it, okay? So remember, that when you change address, let's say you're now living in a different place, try to go to your poster, yeah, and update your profile, your information, put in your new address. They tell them that, hey, I'm no longer living here. This is my new address. So that whenever they post something for you, so that it will not get missing, okay? Put your new information there, your new address, your new phone number. If you have changed phone number, put your new phone number. Tell them you want to do aggiornamento, update. Also, the same thing you can do in Questora also. Go to Questora and communicate to them your new address, your new phone number, your new contact, so that they can contact you whenever they need you, okay? Also, Agencia del Entrate, you can go there also and update your information, okay? Especially your address or, your address especially. Or if you are married, you can tell them, hey, I'm married now, put it there. So these are the things you must know to always try to do when you change location, address, phone number, okay? All right. So now moving straight to the next one. Verbale. You'll be thinking, what is this verbale all about? Yes, if you have gone for commission, yes, as a refugee, asilo holder, or any kind of document, after that, when you go to Questura, they call you that, hey, come, you have gotten document. There's this particular certificate they give to you. For 5 years older, they call it verbale de la commissione. Yes, that one you, because now you have been recognized as a refugee, like a certificate recognition, recognizing you, okay? So now that particular people is very important, even when to apply for Carta, when you want to apply for Nulla Osta as a refugee, you want to apply for Nulla Osta in the UNHCR office to get married, you always be required to bring it. Also, even citizenship, you always be needing these people. So sometimes some camps operators or even SPRA, they play some pranks. You know, after you finish, you have gotten these people, they would like to take it from you. They'll tell you, give it to us. And it's not good, man, because sometimes some people have gone back to require it from them, and they tell them there's nothing like that, you didn't give it to us. That is all. It has entered voicemail, man. So now, also your C3, that's your C3. Remember, I know you all know what is C3 form. That C3 form you filled about yourself, your information, everything, is always also important too. Sometimes you need it in the future. Keep all documents you have in Italy sacred. Keep it safe, man. Go and buy a file and keep uploading all of them there. Put them there. You can even take photos of them and save in your phone, or you can scan them, save in your phones, man. It's very important because you'll be required to provide it in the future. So please, so not that time you start running helter-skelter, thinking, what do you do now? So please, do that, okay? Now, if you need a lawyer, a very good lawyer, who is going to help you fight your cases in appeal or any other matter, this guy is competent. It's not the one that says, Kia, who are you? Do I know you? How do you get my number? This one is very competent, okay? So I'll be giving you his direct phone number so that you can get him, not the one you call office and nobody's speaking, okay? So now, if you are in the Lazio region, Roma, those Lazio region, you know yourself, it will be of good of you to have this guy as your lawyer, man, to use him to fight any of your case out, you know, in appeal or any other issues you want to fight out, okay? This guy is willing to help you. For him, he said he has dedicated his life to migrants. Yes, he speaks English, of course, okay? Yes, also some services he renders are free and very cheap, I'm telling you, very cheap. He charges people, sometimes also free. Yeah, very nice guy, okay? So now, what else? Yes, okay, now moving to the next one, your passport. As a Nigerian, you want to change some information. Informations in your passport, like your name, surname, middle name, date of birth, place of birth, all those things. You want to change them. It's very possible. Though you can do that by going back home with your TC, you know, traveling certificate. You can go with it back home and change it in the immigration office in Abuja. And also, if you want, I have a friend, a guy who have been helping people to do this thing too here. I can just give you his contact. You can speak with him and he will tell you the procedures, how to do it. Yes, no cheating. Ojoro no day. Yes. So please try to contact me if you are in that position of need of these people. Okay. Now, remember that if you are here in Italy, you want a document. There are many ways you can do it. I've been saying it in some of my videos, and this one is another way. Let's say your girlfriend has given birth to a girl. Why did I say girl? Even boys, yes, not only girls. Girls are special, yeah. So now, let's say before that baby clocks 6 months, you can get document through that baby. Yeah. Also, even while your girl is still pregnant, because there's this certificate the doctor will give, I think sometimes after 3 months or 4 months, there about certificate that shows that she's pregnant, you know. With that certificate, that particular certificate that will be given to her and other types that will be given to her by the doctor. Though if you go through a lawyer will put you through very well on these things. So with those certificates, those documents, you can now go to Questora and tell them, hey, I'm expecting a baby, so I need a document. So normally lawyers help very well to do this thing, but sometimes if you know how very well to speak Italian, you can go straight to the Questora and run this thing yourself, and you'll be given a permesso per motivo familiare because you're expecting a baby, so they need you to use it and find a job and take care of that child, you know. So remember, you can do it before 6 months or even while your girl is still pregnant with those certificates. Though if you ask a lawyer, they'll put you through, okay, like I said before. So you'll be getting it. Remember, motivo familiare, you can always convert it to autonomo or lavoro, and when you convert it, you are now free completely. So that is it. Also remember that instead of you allowing your document to die, and when you go to renew it, as others with 2 years or subsidiary or whatever about, if you don't have problems with Questora, before it expires and you don't have a job, please try to go to your commercialista and do what they call autonomo, like a self-employed kind of job. Convert it to autonomo, not converting the document, but just apply for autonomo. So with it, you can present the whatever, all the documents of your autonomo to Questora when going to renew your documents. With that, you renew it easily without problem, because if you don't bring anything that shows you work or a self-employed lavoro lo subordinato, Questora normally hands it over to the territorial commission, which will later call you back for another commission again, which is a problem. Most people, when they go for that commission, they don't used to survive it at all. They lose their documents. So please, if you don't get a job, go for autonomo, okay? Go for autonomo. Then when even after renewing this document, you can easily cancel it again, okay? And be free. You can cancel it, you know? And or maybe you find a job, you can still convert it back to lavoro. So that's just a shortcut of escaping all these killing of documenting. All right, another one is this. If you have a child, now you are scared, I don't have a job, how do I renew my document? Because now you have a baby. Don't be scared, because with the baby's birth certificate and other documents you get in the community from the, for the child attached to your own, you Questora will always renew your document for you so easily like that, because you have a baby. So that birth certificate is like a passageway for you, free passage for you to renew documents, okay? So just get that to your head, it's no problem, okay? Questora will do it for you. So that is it. I'll be leaving you with all these things. I'm yours truly, Chi. Okay, remember to like my video, share to your friends on WhatsApp, Facebook, subscribe. Please press that bell for more notification. If you're not getting notification, do one thing, just unsubscribe and subscribe again so that I get notifications. Okay, all right, I'm signing out. I'm Chi. Ciao.